Hello, my name is Cody and I'm with LaunchDarkly. And in this video, I want to take you on an in-product tour of the different ways that we can enable or disable feature flags within the platform. We have a number of ways that we can either tie in integrations externally, use systems that let you integrate directly, or even schedule them within the platform. So let's jump in and take a look. Right now, we're in a LaunchDarkly project that I use often for a lot of demos I do. There's a couple different flags in here that work in very different ways. The first one we're going to jump into is this maintenance mode flag. Now, typically I use this flag to disable aspects of my application so that users can't access it while I'm doing maybe some critical work on it. The thing about maintenance mode is you typically know when that's going to happen. So it's usually a scheduled thing. You might say I start at 9 p.m. and I run until midnight or something along those lines. So when I think about scheduling out a change, there's two things that come directly to mind. First is this idea of the workflow builder. The workflow builder is a brand new feature inside of LaunchDarkly. And what it lets you do is create more complex multi-stage workflows around your flag enablement or disable. You can start off the workflow builder by choosing to have an approver that initiates it or a scheduled time. So if I did a scheduled time, I might choose that this happens at 50. And hit apply. From here, I can start to unlock the other aspects of the actual flag change. I can choose to turn the flags on or off, set rollouts, targeting rules, and default variations. For something like a maintenance mode, I would want that to turn on at the given time. And from there, I'd want to choose what users actually were impacted by that. By default, this flag is an on or off flag. So when it's on, it's impacting everybody. When it's off, it's impacting no one. In this case, though, I want to turn that on, but I also want to create a targeting rule. And I want that targeting rule to let a specific group of people have maintenance mode disabled. So I want my development team to be able to work on the system and test it against like the actual production environment while it's in maintenance mode. I can use segments to bucket users into that dev users group. So I have a configuration in place for my segment that says, hey, any user that's tagged as dev, add to this segment. I can then say dev users receive a disabled flag for the maintenance mode flag. From there, when maybe at the time the maintenance is over, I can schedule the end of it. So I can come in here, I could say, you know, we end this at 10 o'clock at night, hit apply, and then turn targeting off. This workflow ends up being a much broader way of making these changes that encompasses a number of different steps in here that would normally be an administrator going in and setting these up individually. It becomes really powerful when you take into account something that has a progressive rollout. So being able to have different stages of percentages that roll a feature out. That doesn't work as well for a maintenance mode, but if you're maybe changing the theme or a brand of your page and you want to test it against groups, you might say, hey, for the next week, I want to run it at 20% of users. And then for the week after that, I want to run it at 50% of users. So the workflow builder is ridiculously powerful. It's a great way to drive broader flag changes and orchestrate flag changes within your environment. And honestly, make developers and operators happier, not having to spend as much time in the portal driving changes themselves. So when you don't need something that's multi-stage like the workflow builder, you could use just a normal scheduled change within the flag. So if I came in here and I said, hey, I want to make that same concept available. I want everyone who's in the dev group to be disabled, but everybody else enabled. I come in here, hit this down arrow, schedule the changes, and have that flag implement at a given time. Beyond that idea of the scheduled change, I also have the ability to do something called flag triggers. So flag triggers let us bring in external integrations as well as generic integrations. So external integrations like a Datadog or Dynatrace, like I have on the board right now, showing different systems that come in and impact flag changes inside the environment. A generic trigger, though, gives us the ability to integrate in a little bit more of a freeform way. So I might choose a generic trigger, set that targeting to on, save the trigger, and I get a URL back. I think of this a lot in the idea of the pipeline example, where you might have a pipeline that at start enables maintenance mode, kicks off its pipeline changes for the application, and at the end disables maintenance mode. So we'll take this one for a quick live spin. Go over here so we can see our application's running. We're going through and we're actually toggling out or testing out an API right now. I can come in here, do a post, against that URL that I was given. And we can see that maintenance mode has now turned on for the environment. So maintenance mode is running now. I'm not able to access it even as a dev user. Now, if I want, in this case, the dev users to be able to access it, I can come back in, go into targeting. I can add that rule that I talked about a little bit ago, come into groups, ends with dev, have it disable, save those changes. And we can see that I'm able to actually receive those flag values now. So the targeting rule is still on. It's just receiving a different configuration for the user group that I have configured as a result of that. Now, again, with the pipeline example, you might have the end of the pipeline actually have that triggered off. So I can come in here. I can choose this to set it off. Once again, run my call post against that URL. Hit that. And my maintenance mode turns off and is back to normal again. So can't see it there. But if I come back into the platform, we can see maintenance mode is turned off. Likewise, I might come into something like my database migration configuration. Come in here, set up a trigger to turn off that that flag and turn off the migrated database back to the local one. Save the change, copy this flag. Once again, call my API. And we can see that API changes, and now I'm receiving a different set of data because I'm calling my local database instead. The final example I want to show is the idea of the flag prerequisites. So if I come back into that DP info flag that I was just in, you'll see that I have this prerequisite message here. What this means is that this flag and another flag are effectively linked to one another. This flag is the prerequisite flag, which means that no matter what the other flag is set to, on or off, it will only register as on when this flag is on as well. So with this flag off, even though this DB migrate is turned on, it doesn't evaluate as true because this flag is already off. Once I turn that flag on, this flag will start to evaluate as true as well. So this gives you a way to create somewhat conditions between flags that say, hey, I know that these two things are hard linked to each other. This DB migrate flag relates back to the schema of my database configuration. That only applies if the DB is connecting to the new one. So when this turns on and the new one's in place, it's able to actually use that new schema because this one is enabled as well. We care a lot about developer workflow at LaunchDarkly because we know that everybody works differently and people have different requirements and needs and frankly ways that they want to work with a platform. For people who want to be in the LaunchDarkly UI, we give you the ability to schedule out changes as well as use the workflow builder to orchestrate a broader set of changes, including things like flag values and approvals and targeting rules and rollout percentages. When that fails, you have the default toggle on, toggle off capability within the platform. For systems that want to integrate externally, we have the flag trigger system where we can start to bring in external systems like Dynatrace or Honeycomb or Datadog and have them make changes to our flag values. The generic trigger allows us to bring in pipeline tools and have pipeline tools or other integration platforms call flag values to enable or disable, like the maintenance mode example of running maintenance mode on at the start of a pipeline run. This is just a small sliver of the different ways that you can use LaunchDarkly to drive flag changes into an environment. We'd love to hear more about how you're using it today. Until the next time I see you, though, I hope you learned something new and have a great day.